The Tomb Kings of Khemri are the undying rulers of Nekakhara, an ancient civilization and mighty empire that ruled almost 2,500 years before the birth of Sigmar Heldenhammer. Of all those who would seek power with necromantic magic, only the Tomb Kings can truly claim mastery over it. Hello there. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint your Tomb Kings of Khemri Tomb Guard to a battle-ready standard, and then some extra details as well. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. These colours are perfect for getting your Tomb Kings of Khemri painted quickly and to a battle-ready standard. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about our paints and painting techniques. Right, we've sprayed our model with Grey Sear Spray to give us a nice light base coat to work from. Let's get painting. For our first paint, we'll use Retributor Armor to pick out all of the gold details with a medium layer brush. Even though Grey Sear is a light undercoat, we'll need a couple of thin layers of gold to get good coverage. Try not to get it on other details, as we'll have to tidy up with Grey Sear. If you get lost as to where the gold details are, just remember to check the box art for help. With the gold details done, we just need to move on to the silver ones. For the silver details, we'll be using Lead Belcher and a medium layer brush to paint the blade. Once that's done, don't forget to clean out your water pot and get some fresh water before carrying on. We don't want any metallic flakes in the rest of our paints. Okay, time to do the red details. We're going to use Blood Angel's Red straight from the pot and apply it all over the areas where we want it to be red. These include some of the details on the shield as well. Just check the box art if you're lost as to where these details are. Try to be as neat as possible here, but if you do make any mistakes, tie it back up with Grey Sear and then the previous colours. With the red picked out, it's time to move on to the blue details. For the blue details, we'll be using Talazar Blue straight from the pot and picking out the base of the shield and the alternate patterning that we can find on his helmet and chest armour. Again, try to be as neat as possible here when doing it. Take your time and work through the details slowly. Nice! Our blue and red details are done, and the Tomb King champion is really starting to come together. Alright, we're going to move on to the leather details next, and for this we'll be using a small layer brush as well. Try to be precise, as this is a dark contrast, so we'll stain other areas very easily. We'll just make our way around the model looking for any armor straps that we can find. With that complete, we now need to do the inside of the shield. We need to paint the inside of the shield, and for this we'll use Wildwood and a medium layer brush. Nice and quick stage, load up with Wildwood and let the contrast do all the work for you. Once that's dried, we're moving on to doing the old linen over the bones. Okay, we're almost done. We need to pick out the linen we can see wrapped around the skeleton. We also need to pick out his beard and weapon grip. For this, we'll be using Black Templar straight from the pot and a medium layer brush. Black Templar is a great contrast paint for this, as it has a slight blue tone that will work nicely by looking pale on the raised edges when the contrast paint pulls away from them, giving us an easy, worn and ancient look. Because it's a darker contrast, just be as neat as you can going around the model. If you get it on any of the bones, tidy that up so we're ready for the next step. Nice, we're almost done. We need to do the bones now, but before we do, we'll just give them the once over with Grey Sear first. We don't want any stains showing through when we apply the perfectly named skeleton horde straight from the pot all over the bones. Give the paint some time to dry, and then our Tomb Guard champion is almost done. Just the shades to go before he's battle ready. For our first shade, we'll be using Reichlin Flesh Shade and a medium layer brush to apply it all over the gold. Make your way around the model, picking out the gold details. A good tip here is to look out for any pooling in the recesses or over larger flat areas. Once that's done, we just need to pick out the silver details. We'll be using Nuln Oil to wash over the silver blade. Nice and simple step, but again, just remember to watch out for pooling like before. With that last shade done, our Tomb Guard champion is now battle ready. You could stop here and use these colours on the rest of your Tomb Guard, or you could keep going and use these extra tips and tricks to make our Tomb Guard really come alive on the battlefield. For our first highlight, we're going to use Wild Rider Red and a small layer brush to pick out the red details. We're going to add some water to our Wild Rider red so it's nice and thin and flows well off our brush, carefully gliding our brush along the edges so we can keep a nice and consistent line. If we make a mistake here, we can just tidy back up with Grey Seer and then Blood Angel's red. With that complete, we're going to move on to the blue. For the blue details, we'll be doing the exact same thing. We're going to use Blue Horror and a small layer brush to pick out the blue edges. Remember to add some water to your mix so it's not too goopy when you're trying to do your highlights. Remembering to glide along the edges with the side of our brush where we can as well. Okay, one final edge highlight to go. For our last edge highlight, we're going to use Stormhost Silver and a small layer brush to pick out the most raised edges and corners of the gold. When highlighting metallics, really try to keep your edge highlights as thin as you can, as this will help to sell the fact that they are a very hard and metallic surface. Stormhost Silver is quite a thin layer paint already, so just add a little bit of water to it to help it flow nicely off your brush. Our Tomb Guard Champion is looking awesome. Just one final paint to go. This last stage will be a very light dry brush over the bone, leather, linen, and shield details. We're going to use Screaming Skull and a medium STC dry brush for this. Get a load of Screaming Skull onto your paintbrush and work off most of the paint on a paper towel, working the remaining pigment into your brush's bristles. Then, very lightly brush over the raised details, allowing your bristles to pick them out gently. A good tip here is to be light and as minimal as you can. Remember, it's always easier to add more if needed than it is to take away if it's too much. And there we go. With that last dry brush done, our Tomb Guard Champion is complete and ready to lead his unit into battle. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel or head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.